let's pray for Seth Troxler. This is funny. I guess off the back of the whole paying for our manager's life post that I was ripping the other day, I guess most of my frustration, anger came more so because, you know, I look up to Seth Troxler, someone that I kind of think is amazing, someone that maybe even kind of played a big role in getting me into DJing in the first place. And then on the other end of the side, on the other end of the scale, you've got someone like Carl Cox, who I've always thought was a bit of a wanker ever since he did that RA podcast interview back in the day and blamed the London riots on too many kids in the UK listening to fucking, what do you say, R&B or something. He's always seemed like a bit of a coconut. But that's by the by. But I think with the Seth thing, a lot of people in the scene were just disappointed in it because he speaks up really well for the scene. He advocates well for the community and people that are in it, and he just seems like a one of us in it. So for him to be so detached from reality, right, and to be so oblivious of how he's perceived, it just didn't make any sense. That video was just a whole lot of cringe. So I guess ever since then, any post he puts up on social, people immediately just post about, oh, how's your manager doing? Is he okay? And I guess this is a good example of it. This is one from the other day. He's kind of talking about some podcast that he was on. And if you go in the comments, it's like, look, the first one, how's your manager doing? And then one here again, are you going to ask people as well to donate money in order to read it like you did asking for us to support your tour managers instead of you and your fellow millionaire colleagues? People aren't really that mad, I think, again, mostly because of people at home. So I think if you're Seth and you're his mate, you probably need to tell him, look, don't take any of those comments too personally, right? People are just bored and they're at home and you end up doing a thing that they don't like and they just want, you know, to kind of let off a bit of steam. But it's also a part of you, if you're Seth, where you're like thinking, hold on, if people are coming after me this hard, you know, based on something that minor, it's, don't get me wrong, it was a dickhead thing to do, but it, in the grand scheme of things, it's not that big of a deal. He should be asking himself, like, do people just not like me? Because that's generally a thing that happens, isn't it, with people in counseling culture or cancel culture, is that it usually happens. They usually turn the knife in or twist the knife in when it's somebody they don't like. So they look for any opportunity for you to kind of slip up, make a mistake. And as soon as you do, they pounce on it. And then they kind of want to hound you out and completely get rid of you because they never liked you to begin with. But then 2.5 would be like, if you're one of Seth Troxler's friends, you have to tell him that, hey, the people commenting on the side aren't necessarily your fans. Yeah, because you would like to think if Seth put on a show tomorrow at some venue that was handing out 50 people and he'd sell it out in seconds, right, he's still gonna, you know, draw in a lot of people to come see him play in clubs. So there's not as if like the majority of his fans are turned off to his music, because there's people that was in the middle and probably not fans of his already that are the ones commenting or the ones that are getting most annoyed by the whole situation. But it continues here, it says, can you donate to your fans? We supported you in the past. Now a lot of your fans lost a job. Are you going to help them? Which is wild. That's true, actually, isn't it? Like, there's no people, like, you know those festivals where, I think it's maybe Italy, right, where all the fans are, like, screaming and shouting and whistling and whatever it may be. Those are probably some of the best crowds to play to, right? Some places in Ireland too are like, I forgot what the festival is, maybe the AVA festival, where it seems as if, like, the crowd is, like, you know, like they've all been mollied up, they've all been, you know, electrocuted, and they're just going for it. It's a real it's a real electric environment, let's say. You would think that there could be a rationale or reason for some partners to be like, hey, we supported you, we gave you one of your best clubbing experiences ever, you know, and they give you a screenshot of some post you put on Instagram stories, and I've lost my job and I was that guy in the front row. Why don't you support me now? Why don't you make a fundraiser for me so that I can, you know, continue living? Why don't you do that? And they're not. And instead, they're giving you these selfie videos of them telling you to make sure their tour manager's safe. It's like, oh, that was so tone deaf, man. He's going to have to regret that for a long time, man. Tour manager, fundraiser. It's like, what? It continues here. It says, profiteer. It said, did you pay for your manager? Pay your manager. Pay your tour manager. Seriously, you are asking for money to young people in this period. I hope your video will become viral and show to all your fans and everyone your real face. Like, people are mad as hell. God almighty. It says, hey, you're fucking tour manager, so how much did you exactly contribute to pay to your manager? It just keeps going on and on and on. It says, look, have you started OnlyFans account to support your tour manager? Give us a link. God almighty. But yeah, ever there was a moment in this whole time during the whole lockdown for celebrities to just not be online and to not be putting their face front and center, now is a moment. This is a way to practice a little bit of humility and just take yourself away from the conversation. No one wants to hear from anyone that's a celebrity or well-known figure. They don't want to hear it. They want you to just shut the fuck up and just enjoy your millions, because the moment they see your face, it's probably a reminder of just how affluent you are, or how well off you are, how, you know, far away they are from you. I don't know, that's probably a thing that they're thinking. But Jesus, man, I feel for Steph Troxler, to be honest. I hope it gets better for him soon online, but I'm sure he is not worried about it.